Hello everyone. Good morning, good evening, or good afternoon, depending on when and from where you are watching it. Today we are going to talk about how Visio and Teams could be used together to make collaboration even easier using visuals. Before we go into the topic, a brief introduction about the speakers. I am Shilpa and I'm a program manager on Visio team. Some of the areas that I look into are integration of Visio with Teams, integration of Visio with Power Automate, with Word, with Power BI. With me today, I have Triptish, who will now introduce herself.
Hi, everyone. I am Triptish, and I'm a program manager with Visio team, working on collaboration and other broadening reach initiatives for Visio. Welcome to this session, and I hope you find this insightful.
So let's talk about today's agenda. We will talk about how Visio and Microsoft 365 are tied together, what role basically Visio plays in total collaboration scenario and Teams. We will show it through you a demo, and then we'll talk about the roadmap, what things are already there, what capabilities would be coming soon, and what you can expect in near future. Then we have something interesting, one concept that we are right now working on, wherein Visio would be working as a canvas in Teams meetings. Microsoft 365 and Visio are better together. Visio allows you create a lot of diagrams, collaborate on them with your team members, link them to data to see metrics on top of the diagrams that you create. Visio integrates very well with all these different apps within the Microsoft ecosystem. So let's see how it is actually integrated with the other apps. How Visio is integrated with Microsoft Teams, you can create, view, edit, and collaborate on your Visio diagrams within Teams. You can in fact pin it as a tab, and that will make your collaboration even easier. Visio also integrates with Power BI, wherein Visio diagrams can be embedded into Power BI dashboards and bring those to life. It integrates with Power Automate, wherein you can take your processes to Power Automate for Automate with very few single steps. It integrates with Excel, wherein you can create process diagrams out of data which is there in Excel and keep them updated. With PowerPoint, you can create a PowerPoint deck out of the diagram, wherein Visio will basically break down the diagram into smaller pieces and takes it directly to PowerPoint. And similarly with Word, so process diagrammers basically take a lot of time to create a document. So with a single click, basically this helps you to create a document, Word document with different pieces with all the data which is stored in your diagram right into the Word document. With Visio plan, it also comes with OneDrive for Business, which helps you to keep your diagram on cloud and very easily accessible. We also have Azure Shapes, so many different types of shapes, upgraded shapes, you will see all there in Visio. Let's learn from Triptish more about collaboration, how collaboration capabilities in Visio can help you.
Thank you, Shilpa. So let's understand why collaboration is important. Collaboration is an inherent aspect of the diagramming lifecycle for a user. Starting right from preparing a diagram to sharing it with the wider audience, it has become a basic expectation of a web platform. The expectation of a web app is to be able to help user communicate and co-author with confidence, all this while maintaining a certain level of control. Now, we've heard from our customers asking for more collaborative features in Visio for the web, and we know that the enterprises use this as a key parameter while evaluating different diagramming tools. This, along with the fact that our key compete positions itself as a visually collaborative platform, makes a very strong case for the investment in this area. Keeping our efforts in line, Visio has been investing to provide more collaborative capabilities to our users. Earlier this year, we launched one of the most productivity-enhancing features in Visio for the web, that is real-time co-authoring. With the introduction of co-authoring, multiple users can now simultaneously edit the diagram anytime, anywhere, and stay updated with the changes by other co-authors reflecting in real-time on the canvas. This, along with the new design in the co-authors gallery, which allows you to quickly and easily understand who else is there in the document with you, where they are in the document, and what exactly are they doing in the document, helps you avoid conflicts while working with others on the canvas. The sharing and reviewing capabilities also add to the powerful suit that this Visio web diagramming tool is. In fact, I believe that Teams, being a naturally collaborative platform, when combined with Visio's advanced capabilities, can help users collaborate more effectively and generate beautiful visuals. What do you think, Shilpa?
Yes, Riptish, I agree with you, definitely. We all know that Microsoft Teams is the hub for collaboration where you find all your colleagues, your clients, your vendors. So Visio in Teams takes the collaboration to next level with various capabilities in Visio. Some of the other capabilities that basically enhances the overall collaboration on Teams are pinning as a tab. So you can just pin a Visio diagram in Teams so that you can find the content right when and where you need. So you need not go and find out. Teams conversations help you to basically attention to your colleagues to get their attention immediately. Visio visual collaboration. So you can also use embedded Visio diagrams inside Power BI in Teams. So that makes like the life really easy. Let's see this through a demo of a real life possible scenario. Let's take an example of Lemna Healthcare, fictitious company, which is working to create a process for emergency care room flow during this pandemic. Consultant from the operations management team is asked to come up with that process. This consultant now opens Teams and create a new Visio file. He need not install any other app. He can do everything inside Teams. As you can see here, he uses Visio cross-functional flowchart from so many other types of stencils and shapes available to put up the first draft of the process. Easy drag and drop, smart connectors made his job easier and save a lot of time. You can see there are so many tools and techniques in Visio which helps to put this first draft. Now, when the first draft is ready, the consultant needs to review it with the whole team and share this diagram. What can that consultant do? He can just go to the Files tab. As you can see, this file is right here in the Files tab. That consultant can just go and click on the three dots, make this as a tab. By pinning it as a tab, ensures that co-authors are able to quickly access, review, and edit the diagram when and where needed without wasting time on searching for the file. Also, the consultant can just keep a note, just drop a note to the entire team so that they can have a look and draw their attention to this particular diagram. Now, once the diagram is there, let's see how Visio makes the review process really easy and seamless. Titish, could you please walk us through that?
So the consultant has shared the file with other users in the system. They all enter into the file and the consultant can see in the top right corner who else is there in the file with him, who else is present, where they are on the file, what they're exactly doing. The user can expand the person card and go to the exact location of the other co-authors. On the location, show who else is there, and it can show whether the user is viewing or editing, the editing being represented by the three dancing dots. Now let's see how users can work together in Visio. One of the users here, as you can see, has the Visio file open in the browser. However, the other user here has the file open in Teams. The multiple users can now work together and see each other's changes happening in real time as they occur on the canvas. All this while opening the file at different endpoints. You can see new shapes being added. You can see the swim lanes being moved and being reflected to the other user very quickly. This is how easy it has become working with Visio for the web with this powerful productivity enhancing tool. Along with that, any changes like theme or layout or sizing, all this reflect in real time to the other users in the canvas. And you can see who else is editing as shown here by the three dancing dots. So now the consultant has shared the file with others for feedback, and you can see the other users in the hospital system commenting on the file and sharing their feedback through comments in the editor. The commenting facility can be leveraged in the view mode as well and the edit mode as well, allowing users to share feedback very quickly. But not just that, Visio in Teams also offers you multiple other powerful capabilities like leveraging the conversations or the chat feature where you can converse live with the other participants in the document or even at mentioning users, which can get the user's attention and get you the responses very fast. With this, overall, the users can very efficiently communicate and collaborate with other users in the system, and the consultant was hence able to complete the diagram and the review process for it. Well, with that demo, I'm really excited to see what our users can achieve with these new capabilities. But we don't stop here. We will continue our momentum and bring great features to you. So let's see what does the future of collaboration in Visio and Teams looks like. I'll be discussing this segment in three parts. We will first talk about what we've released, what is coming soon, and what the future plan is. So earlier in this year, we launched real-time co-authoring, which is one of the most productivity-enhancing features. And then we introduced the great capability in Teams, such as creating new Visio files and pinning it as a tab for quick reference. And soon you will see that with Collaboration Gallery, Modern Presence Enhancement, and some of the Teams and commenting improvements coming your way, generally available to all. Continuing our momentum, we are bringing mind mapping in Visio for the web, where we are working with the Fluid team to enable it in various apps, such as Teams, OWA, Whiteboard, and OneNote. We are also working at enabling modern comments and at mentions in Visio for the web so that the collaboration for you becomes easier and faster to review. Teams and Visio, as Shilpa just talked about, enables quite a lot of scenarios. So we are looking to make the Visio app available in meetings and tab kind of scenarios where the collaboration becomes more easier. Well, this is in early stages right now, but we are looking at possibilities where users can share a file within a team, a Visio file within a meeting, and the other users can co-create the diagram. Shilpa will be talking about this exciting feature shortly in some more detail. We are also exploring features like versioning in Visio for the web, catch-up highlights, and some of the things in intelligence area like VisioBot for Microsoft Teams. Lastly, I want to say that as the Visio web app, which was launched a couple of years ago, it is maturing, we see an opportunity of serving a wide variety of users. Our goal is that all kind of users, whether their need is just basic diagramming to a specialized one, everyone should have access to a readily available canvas that they can access across the applications. And that is what our theme for this year looks like. And so we request you to share your feedback with us and let us know what other collaborative capabilities and integrations you'd like to see in Visio for the web. With this, I request Shilpa to walk us through the Visio in Teams meeting concept.
Thank you, Triptesh. So Visio as a canvas for Teams meeting. This is one concept that we are exploring and we would love to hear your feedback on it. So what Teams and Visio can do together? Teams meetings give you the capabilities like audios and video, which help you to synchronously put something first draft. And Visio basically can help you to get a reusable output, which will be ready for further iterations. So these two capabilities together can help you communicate with each other and collaborate on ideas very effectively using visuals. Also, the output will be a professional looking diagram, and you will be able to create it right when and where you need, that is during meetings. So just to repeat once again, this is a concept that we are exploring and we would love to hear your feedback on it. So Visio for Teams meetings, there are certain kind of scenarios for it. The first one is when you want to ideate visually with your team on a shared canvas and work towards the focused goal. So you want to work through Scratch. Some of the example scenarios could be when you want to define a process, when you want to basically create a timeline because you're starting with a new project. It could be a resource planning where you would need org chart, and it could be any business diagram where you want to talk about, you know, strength, weaknesses through some frameworks like SWOT analysis, fishbone analysis, etc. Another scenario could be wherein you already have some kind of visual and you want to discuss and refine on that particular visual. Visio will help you definitely over there too. Some of the scenarios, because you already have a process diagram, and because you already have that process effective in your system, but you want to improve on it, you can just pull up the diagram and you can start working on it. If you have status meetings, so you can just use the existing org chart or timeline to do the status meeting. Review meetings, if you have any kind of design meetings, design reviews like wireframes, floor plan, business metrics, you can use an existing diagrams and make the changes right during the meetings. You can also import AutoCAD drawings. So the third scenario could be communicate your point effectively. So The idea probably here might not be just to save any visual, create any visual for further use, but just to communicate your idea, your point to the audience. For example, some of the scenarios could be during interviews, wherein some contextual shapes will help you, network shapes, technical design diagrams, wireframes, etc. In the education sector, you can also find relevant diagrams over here, which will help you to basically explain your point better in trainings and in knowledge transfers. And there could be like many other scenarios. Now let's see it through a demo. When you have meetings already set up, you can just go and edit that meeting to add a Visio file, or I would say Visio template, or a Visio plan canvas to be used inside the Teams meetings. That user can just go to add a tab, find the Visio app over there, trigger it, add the app, and now can choose the required template or the relevant template from so many options given over here. This will result in creating a Visio file which can directly be edited inside the Teams meetings. Here you can see all the users are in meeting already, triggered the Visio board, and they have started co-authoring in this particular diagram. They are giving their inputs while they are actually talking to each other, which is making them really productive. Because otherwise, what would have happened? They could have given their inputs, and somebody would have taken notes, and then somebody else would have just created a visual out of it to make it look better and to take out insight faster. Here, everything is happening right then and there. People are talking to each other, people can see each other and give their inputs and suggestions in the diagram. This is another example wherein a blank canvas is being used. User can just select the type of shape, contextual shapes. As you already know that Visio has thousands of out-of-box shapes. Here we are using cross-functional flowchart. Each one of the meeting user has been assigned a swim lane and they can just start creating this particular process. Because we know that any process will be created by taking inputs from not just one, but more than one person in the organization where the process has to be implemented. And as you can see, it becomes like really easy when they are brainstorming, when they are discussing about the diagram, they are actually able to see it then and there itself as they are giving inputs right inside the diagram. And by the end of it, you will see that the input is actually ready. The output is their suggestions have been taken as a visual and which can be iterated further. This file can be saved. This file can be exported as a PDF. This file can be exported into a PowerPoint deck and so forth. As I said, that this is the concept that we are exploring right now. We are also looking for customers who can help us to visualize it, to work, to basically design it. So if you want to pre-sign up for it, please click on this link or just scan the QR code and fill this survey up. Thank you all for watching this session. If you want to learn even more, I would encourage you to check out the other sessions. On the screen, you can see there are many other sessions which will help you to learn and know more about Visio and the capabilities. Also, you can get in direct touch with us via some of the channels that you can see over here. We would love to hear your feedback and suggestions. Thank you for your time. Goodbye.
Thank you for attending the session. Hope this was insightful for you. Goodbye.